Hey everybody, welcome back to another Stardew Valley episode. So, without further ado, let's get right into it. We don't want to miss any time. We are on the 9th of spring of year 1. So, yeah, let's just jump right into it. Let's grab the copper bar that we made. We're going to keep making those gradually. Let's grab some more copper and stick it in there before we head out. Just like that. And each of them, I did find out, takes a half an hour in-game time. So I did not know about that. And let's check outside. Do we have any plants right now? I'm pretty sure we don't have any. Yeah, so we don't need to get any of that stuff out. So the mission for today is going to be to get 300 wood. And I'll tell you guys why. Over here on the map, this, if you guys, in the last episode or so, we checked this bridge over here and it was closed, and it said to repair it we need 300 wood to get to this island. Well, that island is very special because it has coral and urchins, which are very valuable. So like every tip guide and things like that I read said that that's one of the things you should do really early, because it does give you a lot of selling, so it kind of puts some money in your pocket. So what I'm gonna do is, just like everyone tells me to do, I'm going to go ahead and get it quite early. So we're going to chop down some wood. Oh no, don't go into the... Oh no, most of that went into the water. And I did find out something else. So like I read up on a lot of like tip guides and stuff, that if you just leave the stump there, the tree actually grows back. I did not know about that. Please fall... Yes, that way. So yeah, I'm going to be leaving the stumps there so the tree can actually grow back. I don't know why I wasn't leaving the stumps beforehand. But I do need to start doing that. Now, the only problem with getting a riverside farm is that, sadly, there aren't many trees, I don't think. So we're going to really kind of have to scavenge for them for now. So maybe go down here. Ooh, there was a couple pieces of wood that I missed. Yeah, that's kind of our main goal. We want to get 300 wood, and that's going to use most of our wood, but it does open up quite a big kind of place that will be an income source. So every day we could go by there. Okay, I need to get this rock out of the way. So hopefully we'll be able to get enough wood here. And then we might want to start replanting some of these trees soon here. I do not want to just cut all of them down. Oh, we don't have our scythe with us. Oh, darn. Okay, well, that's fine. Just kind of go over here. Now, I'm going to pray that this tree doesn't fall into the water. I think that's enough space, right? One or two went in the water. That's fine, though. Let's pick up that last piece of wood. Mix seeds. Always love myself some mix seeds. And if we don't get it tonight, we might get it the next day. I'm completely okay with that. I'm not gonna be bothered if we don't get it specifically today. We should go check the billboard though, see if there's any special events going on today. We're just gonna kind of keep cutting until we're like fairly out of energy. Because of course, if you guys don't know, walking, stuff like that doesn't take energy. Only stuff that takes energy is general like tasks. Like cutting, breaking, farming, watering. Walking, talking, and stuff like that does not take energy. So we can kind of get our energy bar super, super low and then head out. We have 261, so we're very, very close. Not there just yet, but we are very, very close. Wonder if the tree will fall forward. Nope, still falls sideways. Okay. Move. Alright, and then I think one more tree is doable. Just one more. There we go. Okay, so we have 286. Not there yet. Very, very close. We could probably eat something and get it. But I do want to do some tasks out in the town. Ooh, I'm gonna get my hoe for that. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to stick all this in there for now. And let's grab our... Since we upgrade our inventory, we can actually grab these tools out. Why not? Let's just keep them on us. Oh, there's... Is the worm still there? It is. So let's see what this is. Bam. Clay. Yeah, we really got to watch our energy, though. We really have to watch it. Let's go ahead and stick another copper ore in here. Collect that. So we're kind of out of copper ore, so that's like the last we'll make. But yeah, let's head into town. You know what we'll do? Tuesday. So yeah, we'll grab some gifts we can give to people. You know what? Hold on. We won't give these. We won't give this. Won't give that. So we'll grab these two. Just like that. And then we should probably buy some plants. It's only the 9th. We still got plenty of time to grow spring seeds. So we'll probably head back. Oh, okay. So we've got Lewis here. Oh, hi there. What an eyesore. This is the Pelican Town Community Center, or what's left of it, anyway. It used to be the pride and joy of the town, always bustling with activity. Now, just look at it. It's shameful. These days, the young folk would rather sit in front of the TV than engage with the community. I'm sitting in front of a TV. Lewis. Come on now. But listen to me. I sound like an old fool. Joja Corporation has been hounding me to sell them the land so they can turn it into a warehouse. Pelicatoud could use the money, but there is something stopping me from selling it. I guess old-timers like me get attached to relics of the past. Ah, well. If anyone else buys a Joja membership, I'm just gonna ahead and sell it. So that means me. If I buy a membership, it becomes a warehouse. Sigh, here, let's go inside. What's this? I guess Vincent and Jazz must have been playing in here. This place is even more dilapidated than I remember. Whoa, that's an apple. What? Spooky. What's the matter? Are you ill? You saw something. I wouldn't be surprised if the place was full of rats. There's another apple. Look at it. It's an apple. You're worrying me, Aqua. Oh, come on, Lewis. Look, I think I'm going to head home. I need some lunch. Alright, man, Lewis. Peace out, my dude. Get some lunch. Hey, I'll keep this place unlocked from now on. Maybe you can help catch that rat if you have some extra time. Gotcha. Now, like I said, I've already played through this game a little bit. I'll have to come back and explore this building further. So, kind of know what's up. The building, there's really nothing to do inside of it at all. There's, like, nothing to do other than I know of, except this golden book right here, which has, like, nothing on it except some, like, words. That's literally all you can do in the house for now. I'm pretty sure there's a future cutscene or event that triggers this place to actually do something, but for now, doesn't exactly do much. So we're gonna go ahead and continue our daily activities. Go by Pierre's, and what we're gonna do... Ooh, Abigail, we haven't talked to her yet. I'm not in a good mood right now. Pretty sure she's new. I haven't talked to her yet. Okay, cool. I do all my grocery shopping here. Okay, so let's... So, I also searched up guides, and the main thing that people should buy in the season is cauliflower. So, I'm just going to listen to them and buy some cauliflower. And Yeah, we'll also go back and we will make some fertilizer with our sap. That's another thing that I didn't do beforehand that we really do need to do. We didn't check the board if there's any birthdays or events today. Okay, tomorrow's Vincent's birthday, but nothing else. Did we miss anything? No, we only missed Lewis's birthday. And I just remembered, I was like sleeping yesterday, thinking of what I recorded, and I'm like, oh no, I saw it was Lewis's birthday, but I didn't give him anything. I completely forgot. What up, Sam? So yeah, I forgot Lewis's birthday. Let's see if we can meet the person that runs this animal farm. She's been gone every day. Please be here so I can meet you. No, this person is never here. I swear, like, I always come here and she's never here. So one thing, guys, that I also read on some tip guides is that a lot of people just build, I forgot what it's called. I don't want to get the name wrong, but it's like the place that holds the chickens first, because it's like the first one that shows up. It's actually a giant mistake, because it's like 2,000 for that building, 4,000 for that building, and then a lot of money for the chicken, and then each chicken every day gives an egg, which is 25, but you have each time it lays an egg, it takes a hay, which is 50 from Mari, so it's just a giant money drain. What we need to build first is a silo so we can get hay, then build the chickens. How many spots do we have? Even if we do, we can't water all of them. We need energy. I think we're going to have to wait until tomorrow to plant these. Yeah, it looks like we're going to have to wait until tomorrow. Let's go back into town and let's give the gifts then at least. So yeah, we'll wait to plant these tomorrow. Because we'll have energy. And then deeper into the mine, raise the animals. Okay, so can't do any of that. And let's take this out of our inventory. I don't want to be holding anything. Who can we give gifts to? I'm looking for one of the single people. That's who I'm really looking for. Maybe Emily. Where is Emily? Because I know she likes dandelions. So it's kind of like an easy gift to give because I know exactly what she likes. Oh, is this a thing we can do? Park guard, name Vincent. Reading, D. Math, C. Should be sports, A. He's a good boy, but he can make do with an A. A little more studying, Penny. Yeah, it seems like Vincent's good at sports, but I don't know, good for him, but he's kind of in Stardew Valley. Sports aren't going to get you very far here, in my opinion. They don't even have a school, so what's the point of sports? Yo, what up, dude? What up, Sai, mom won't let me have any more gummies today. Yeah, sorry, my dude. Jazz, do you get better grades? Okay, she doesn't want to talk to me. I probably pressed the wrong button, but oh well. Let's talk to Elliot. Your idea can pass through your head when you at least expect it, but if your mind is too busy, you might miss it. Whatever you say, dude. Let's go down on the beach. Let's get some of these worms. Probably run out of energy, but a book. Found a lost book. The library collection has expanded. Cool. So let's see if there's anything else we can kind of pick up. And yeah, this is the place I'm talking about with the 300 wood. I can't go into Elliot's thingy yet. Man, I can't find any of the girls. It's fine though. I don't want to give them gifts anyway. Even though it's just a flower. Maybe they're in town somewhere. Maybe they're in town. What up, Jody? Up, kind of stuck between a couple people here. Okay, can one of you come out? Thank you. Oh, okay, and here's Robin. Hey, if you need any materials or blueprints, my shop is the place for you looking for. All right. Thanks, Robin. I think we're gonna head over to sleep. I'm too lazy to find all the girls to give gifts to, so screw the girls. We won't give them any gifts. So yeah, we'll go to bed now, refill our energy, and have enough to start doing some planting for tomorrow. Stick the shell in there, why not? And we'll also, so yeah, tomorrow we'll focus on getting enough wood and planting the seeds. So let's go to bed. Alright, we got a new burger. Cool. There we go. 9th or 10th of spring, year one. Okay. Let's go over here. I'm not gonna go through this. It literally just teaches you how to make food. Weather report, welcome, your source for news. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Okay, so it's going to be sunny, fortune teller. If you see... Okay. I think you'll have a little extra luck. Okay, so we're not going to do anything special. I've learned that the fortune teller... Ooh. The fortune teller kind of tells you how good of luck you're going to have in the mines and fishing and stuff. Hello, Aqua. Marnie. That's the person we need to meet. You see this dog here? Yeah, Marnie's never at her store. Come on, Marnie. Get your stuff together. Found us sitting outside the entrance to your farm. I think it's a stray, poor thing. Hey, it seems to like this place. Hey, don't you think the farm could use a good dog? Yes, give me... Let's name it... What do we name it? You know what? Bringing it back to my old Pokemon and... Let's name it Misty. Why not? Let's name it Misty. Welcome, Misty. You'd be a great pooch now, okay? Yeah. Of course, Misty is my favorite Pokemon trainer, so, you know. My sister told me that you've been poking around inside the old community center. Why don't you pay me a visit? The wizard! Ooh. Dear farmer, I'd like to apologize for joking about your grandpa's old cottage when we first met. It's really nice. However, you might need some more space someday. That's where I can help. First, it includes a kitchen. With the kitchen, you'll be able to cook any recipes. Okay. So she's telling me I can upgrade my stuff. Okay, so yeah, let's go ahead and first start planting the cauliflower. Oh, another thing some of the guides told me is always show hit locations. It's like that. I think this is a little too much space, but... Now that I'm started, I have to finish with a symmetrical shape or something. Okay. Start planning. Okay, come on. There we go. So 8 more. Yeah, we're not gonna have enough space to fill the entire thing, but that's fine. And then one up here. So let's start watering everything. So yeah, the hitbox can kind of be annoying, but it kind of helps with your aim a little bit, and I don't mind it. Hopefully it doesn't take away from the whole farming experience. I mean, it is a 2D pixel game, so I don't know. Hopefully it doesn't bother you guys. If it does bother you guys, you can tell me in the comments and I'll turn it off. But I might turn it on and off, I maybe just toggle it. Alright, but there is all our stuff watered. Let's go ahead and get the rest of the wood that we need. So let's go inside. There's the dog. Let's get the rest of the wood that we need. And also, I think we can fill up the dog's bowl, right? Yeah, we can fill it up. Cool. Okay, so let's head down to... We can chop down like one tree and go ahead and get it. And we could also stop by the wizard's place today if we do have enough time. Alright, one tree right there. Oh, come on. Let me through. Let's cut it down. Is this a fully matured tree? I don't even know if it's fully mature. I think it is. I don't know if there's like in-between stages. 99, we need one more. So we'll just hit one of these. Okay, cool. So let's go down. Maybe Marty's gonna be at our store finally. That'd be a sight. So does this mean that we met her? Marnie. Yeah, so we did meet her. Okay. Okay. We still got a couple people to meet. Only like one or two. But okay, so that event triggered it where we do see her, which is cool. So she's finally at her store. Purchase animals. So yeah, can't purchase anything yet because we don't have a coop. I think that's what it's called. I hate not knowing names, but yeah. But it is not worth to buy just yet. Because, again, every day that we keep it running is actually a loss for us. I forgot that. We need to go make sap. We need to go do that to fertilize our thing. And it's Vincent's birthday, I'm pretty sure. You know what? Let me look up what he likes for his birthday. And, of course, I got my trusty phone. I think at least once an episode I take out my phone and Google something. Because, guys, this game is honestly a lot about Google. Not knowing things. Vincent, Stardew Valley. Let's see what he likes. I don't care. What does he like? He likes daffodils. Okay, we can give him a daffodil. I don't know why he likes daffodils, but he does. Yes, fix this. Yeah, just like that. This is literally this one piece of land that unlocks, but the nice thing is this land gives us a good bit of profit. There's like always shells and coral and urchins, and this stuff can fetch a good little price. So for 300 wood, we've got a steady supply of money coming from here, which is always nice. Meet the wizard. Okay, so yeah, we'll go ahead and meet the wizard. Let's head back up, see if we can find Vincent real quick to get that over with. Vincent, where you at, man? Need to give you something. Okay, I think Vincent lives in this house, right? No, he lives in the other house. Just in a random guy's house. I always thought that it's weird about this game. It's not very realistic. No one actually walks inside of other people's houses like this. Is he in the kitchen? No, okay. So yeah, I don't know where the kid is. If we find him, maybe we'll talk to him. But yeah, let's head over to the Wizard's Tower. And see what we have to do there. Yeah, the Wizard Tower is right over here. And I'm pretty sure that I think it's up here, right? Yeah. So over here in this den. Ooh, I'll take that. Thank you. And yeah, this is the Wizard's Tower. So we haven't been here yet. Partly because there was no need to. Just yet in the game. So I didn't bother coming. But now that he called us over here, I'll take that. We can actually go to him. Actually, we have been over here, but it was locked. I forgot. Spooky. Wizard. Ah, come in. I am Rasmodeus, seeker of the arcane truths. Mediary between physical and ethereal, master of the seven elements, keeper of the sacred. Yeah, you get the point. And you, Akko, the one whose arrival I have long foreseen. Here, I'd like to show you something. Behold. It's an apple. It's the apples that we saw at the community center. Spooky. You've seen this before, haven't you? They call themselves the Junimos, mystery spirits. These ones, for some reason, they used to speak with me. I'm not sure why they've moved into the community center, but you have the reason to fear them. But you have no reason? I didn't read that fast enough. Or I read it too quickly. You found a golden scroll written in unknown language. Most interesting. Stay here, I'm going to see myself. I'll return shortly. Okay. He's just kind of poofed away. Nanny came in the door. I found the note. The language is obscure, but I was able to decipher it. We, the Junimo, are happy to aid you. In return, we ask for gifts of the valley. If you are the one with the forest, then you will see the true nature of the scroll. One with the forest. What do they mean? Sniff, sniff. Whoa. Aha! Come here. Okay. My cauldron is bubbling with ingredients from the forest. Baby fern, moss grub, caramel top toadstool, can you smell it? Sounds kinda gross, my dude. Here, drink up, let's see the essence of the forest permeate your body. Let's do it. Nervousness, teardrop. Gulp, gulp, gulp. Nope. Green. The forest has entered me. Spooky leaves. That's a tree. That's another tree. Is there a third tree? There's the third tree. There's three trees. Four trees? Five trees? No more trees? Six trees? Seven trees? Is there an eight? Can I get an eight? Nope, it's only seven. Seven trees. Only seven. You've gained the power of forest magic. Now you can decipher the true meaning of the Jumino scrolls. Sick, man. Let's do it. Okay, so here, let's go ahead. Head up back to our farm. We'll make some fertilizer and put the fertilizer on our cauliflower. And then we'll go try to find Vincent. And I think it's going to be the end of the episode here shortly. Yeah. So this day will be the last day on this episode. But yeah, guys, so if you guys don't know what fertilizer does, it just gives you a better chance of the cauliflower being a higher quality. It gives you, like, a silver or gold star. But what's special about it is cauliflower already gives you a good amount of profit. I'm going to sell that and that. I'm selling this. Actually, maybe I should keep the stuff in here for now. Just keep that stuff in here. But it just gives you even better sap. We won't waste all of our sap because we might need some for a different crafting recipe, but... must be added before planting. Are you kidding me? Oh, no. I just added that there by accident. Can we, like, until that? Great. Well, all these are just going to be normal plants. I guess we'll save the fertilizer for next season. That's fine. Next season is summer, which is, like, the bountiful season. For now, though, I am going to sell these because I need money for more plants to use the fertilizer on, I guess. So I will sell these. No, I won't sell those just yet. You know, we'll plant these. So we'll need... okay, I guess we'll grab these. Let's plant the mixed seeds then, I guess. And see what we get out of them. So yeah, let's plant. Bam. So let's fertilize this, this, and this. Let's plant the rest of the mixed seeds. And see what we get, and then we gotta water them, of course. And we'll see what we get. And let's go ahead and in here we'll stick all of those, like, seashells and stuff. Let's go ahead and organize our thingies. There we go. So, let's go ahead and try to find Vincent. It is his birthday. It's another daffodil. That's what he likes. Daffodils are really good presents, because most people like them, actually. The people that are cool, in my opinion, like him at least. So let's go ahead and try to find him. But yeah, that was a major mistake. I should have. Looks like a good day to play catch, huh? I'd ask you to throw the ball around, but you don't really seem like the sports type. I hate sports, but for the sake of the game, let's make them like us. Really, I guess I underestimated you. My arm's a little sore, but maybe next time. Yeah, in reality, I really, really don't like sports. But for the sake of the game to make friendships, I'll tell them I do. I'm a liar, but that's fine. Oh no, I thought it was Where? Oh, there he is. Come here. Dude. A birthday gift. That's very kind of you. I love it. Yeah, you're welcome. What's your name? Penny. We don't have school here, but I'm doing my best to give Vincent just the proper education. Is Penny single? Penny single. She is. Here, take this. Do you like this? Thanks, this looks nice. Okay, I don't know if she likes that. Whatever. Haley, we haven't met her yet. The only thing I like about this town is the beach. So, we finally met her. Who have we not met? The only one we haven't met is Shane. No. Is that Shane? I swear that's Shane. I know from... No, this is Shane. Whatever his name is. So, no, I didn't mean a cast. Introductions. Yeah, we only need one person. What is his name? You know, let me look it up. I'm gonna Google it once again. Second time during the episode, I'm gonna Google something. Why is everyone in this place? Stardew Valley characters. Let's go see if we can meet him today. If we can meet him today, we could finish our introductions today, which would be nice. His name's Sebastian. That's his name, Sebastian. He's one of the 12 available, lives in the basement of his mother Robin's carpenter shop north of town. Where is Robin's? Okay, so he lives in the basement of Robin's shop, which is this. No, it's this. It's this. And Sebastian Amaru. It's already closed, I think. To 5 p.m. Yeah, it's already closed. That feels bad. Alright, so it's getting late, I guess. So we should probably spend the rest of our time probably getting some materials. So let's do this. Let's head back to our thing. And let's use the rest of our energy for today on chopping down things and getting rocks. So yeah. I think this is what the rest of our energy should be used on, because we didn't use a lot of energy today, surprisingly. And I'm not going to bother getting the rocks, because... Why does it have to fall in the water? Because we can go to the mine and get plenty of rocks, so I'm not going to bother with those. I'm not going to even bother. Please don't fall in the water. I know some of this is going to fall in the water. Of course, most of it fell in the water. And that triggers me. So, I probably shouldn't have picked the waterland farm. Now, that I kind of regret it a little bit. I do regret it just a little bit. The other farm was... I wouldn't say better, but... It had less space for trees to fall in the water at. It's not, like, terrible. It's kind of just triggering. It's like, oh, come on, why... At least they should have made a game mechanic where I can, like, stop it somehow. See, all those fall in the water. I needed those. I really need the game to stop doing that to me. Like, for real. It's fine, though. I'll get used to it eventually. I'll get used to it and learn how to deal with it. But yeah, we're almost out of energy, so we're going to cut down a couple more trees, and then we'll head back to our house, and it's going to be pretty much good night for tonight. Yeah, just going to get some wood, because we did waste all of it, so we might, if we ever need any wood for some more crafting, well, we know where to get it, or we have some spare. So all we need to make sure is we just go to bed by 12:30, so that's not too late. Now, probably half of this stuff is going to fall in the water, I'm going to guess. Ooh, none of it fell in the water. That's great. This one's going to fall in the water. Wow, okay, never mind. Let's see where this one goes. I'm hoping this one doesn't go towards the water. Okay, it didn't. Wow. It's glorious. Okay. So I think that's all we can do. Let's head back over to the house. Get out of my way, bush. Of course all those fall in the water. That's... Okay. See, now we're kind of slow, but we'll make it in time. What is that? Oh, that's my dog. Hello. Dude, why are you sleeping outside? We have a house. Anyway, guys, so yeah, I might as well kind of start the outro now. So, guys, I had a lot of fun today playing. Hopefully, you guys had a lot of fun watching me play Stardew Valley. It is a great game. Very calming. Very kid-friendly. So, guys, if you did enjoy, you gotta go to bed by 12. That's really all we have to do. But we do gotta get to bed by 12. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to like and comment, as it supports my channel. And yeah, we made a good amount for foraging. Yeah, I keep interrupting my intro. If you guys enjoy, make sure to like and comment, as it supports the channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.